some new innovation in the artificial intelligence space. Startup SandboxAQ says they've unlocked the area of AI that promises to, quote, unlock real economic value through a partnership with Nvidia. They're calling it quantitative AI, and it's already being used by the Army to create hyper-specific metals and batteries. Let's bring in SandboxAQ's CEO, Jack Hidary, as well as early and enthusiastic investor in SandboxAQ and one of NVIDIA's earliest and biggest bulls, Breyer Capital's Jim Breyer. It's good to have both of you on, Jim and Jack. Welcome.
Hi, Sarah. Good to see you.
Yeah, good to see you, too. So,
Sarah,
Jack,
always a pleasure.
Great to have you, Jim. Jack, I want to talk about SandboxAQ and what you're doing. So the A is AI, Q is quantum. When Jim Breyer is excited about something and has been telling me about something for years, you got to pay attention. You spun out of Google a few years ago, chaired by Eric Schmidt. Explain what exactly you do and what this technology edge is that you have.
Sure. Thanks, Sarah. We spun out 2 years ago. We raised $500 million from investors such as Jim Breyer, Breyer Capital, great supporter of ours, T. Rowe Price, Eric Schmidt, Marc Benioff, and so many other great supporters of our company, raised $500 million to scale out a new wave of AI. On CNBC and so many other press talk about LLMs, large language models. At SandboxAQ, Sarah, we focus on large quantitative models. It turns out that 80%, the majority of the economy, depends on quantitative relationships. That could be in asset management and financial services. That's quantitative. You don't want to use ChatGPT for that. It could be in making new battery chemistry for electric vehicles or energy. It could be in biopharma. How do you develop a new drug for Alzheimer's, for cancer, for brain cancer? You do not want to turn to an LLM for that. It's not what it's trained for. We are the leaders and pace setters in LQMs, large quantitative models, and that's our focus of our announcement today with NVIDIA.
Got it. So, Jim, why are you so excited about this?
Well, Sarah, great to be back with you. As you know, I have been pounding the table on NVIDIA for over 3 years now, and this is an example of how there is still a very significant long-term upside in NVIDIA, particularly around areas where they partner with young companies where quantitative modeling, whether it's in the biotech space, whether it's finance, big, very significant simulations that are run in the cloud. And when people ask me, what is it about NVIDIA that keeps you so excited? One of the areas is the NVIDIA cloud. And I think over the next 3 to 5 years, there is enormous upside in NVIDIA in their cloud opportunities with third-party developers like Sandbox, Meta, and in some cases, other very significant mega cap companies.
So that answers that. I was going to ask you after a 180% run-up in the last 12 months, whether you still like it. I guess you do. What, Jim, how do you think about the opportunity for quantitative AI? Beyond NVIDIA, are there any other plays? Is there any other ways that investors should think about this?
Absolutely. I think having visited a number of major boards over the last 6 months in biopharma, in finance, as well as Department of Defense-like applications, these companies all need to run very significant simulations, whether it's molecules in the biopharma space, where Eli Lilly is leaning in hard. And I love the leadership, by the way, of Eli Lilly. Mm. If you think about what finance, a great private equity investment firm, might need to do, Blackstone, KKR, Apollo, the size of the financial simulations continue to increase dramatically. And that is what quantitative simulation and very deep tech running on NVIDIA and AMD, which you know I'm also extremely excited about long term, is helping to generate what will be 2 to 4 years from now a new generation of leaders that have leaned in hard in areas like the NVIDIA cloud, where obviously there is long term very significant upside, in my humble opinion.
Yes, and we should note that you're on the board of Blackstone, so you're bringing that with a little experience in terms of what they're up to there. Jack, how does it work for the U.S. Army? you have military applications, you've signed deals. What does that look like?
Yes, so Sarah, we have customers in the biopharma space, such as Sanofi that we announced before, Flagship Pioneering we're announcing today as well as a key biopharma customer, major platform that spun out Moderna. People have heard of Moderna and many other very famous biotech companies. This is transformative for biopharma, but also, as you mentioned, for defense. The U.S. Army is using our LQMs, our large quantitative models, in two different ways. First, the next generation coming up in the next 4 or 5 years of tanks and military vehicles for the U.S. Army need to be much lighter. They need to lighten up by 40, 50 tons in some cases for the Abrams tank, as an example. How do you do that? You need breakthroughs in new metals, new alloys, new material science. The only way to do that is with a large quantitative model. And we're SandboxAQ is producing those alloy chemistry formulas that'll then get fabricated in Warren, Michigan by the U.S. Army. Second, battery chemistry. Jim mentioned it already. Battery chemistry is fundamental to our economy, not just for vehicles in defense and in civilian life, but also for battery storage of energy. It's fundamentally will change our grid. And so, Sarah, to answer your question as well, building on what Jim just said, a great way to play AI is certainly to choose a couple of AI companies. But a bigger way to play AI is to look at the biggest verticals in our economy. There will be winners and losers. Jim highlighted Lilly, one of the companies starting to really use AI. Sanofi is another one as well. If we look at others in the biopharma space, some not using AI as much. They may not win as much as Lilly and Sanofi. If we go to automotive, we're looking at Stellantis and others starting to really use AI, other car companies not using AI. So there's going to be winners and losers on the AI issue in each of the major verticals in our economy.
Jim, you know, Jack references the military, which reminds me of some comments we got from General Milley the other day about the future of the military, really regarding hardware and humanoids, robots, that kind of thing. I wonder if you think some of those forecasts make sense right now.
Carl, it's going to happen. It won't happen quickly, but what we're seeing, whether it's surgical robots or what General Milley has articulated, and I've had a number of direct conversations with him. The humanoid robots, which of course sounds like science fiction, 5 to 10 years out, will be highly significant. And I've had these same conversations with Doug McMillan at Walmart, where I was a longtime board member. Walmart is leaning in extremely hard into AI, very deep AI. And there will come a time when the humanoid robots become important, but not in the next 5 years, in my humble opinion.
Overall, Jim, do you think there's a little bit of a hype factor or froth factor in the market related to AI? I know you still pounding the table for NVIDIA, like AMD, but some of these other valuations and the market overall, what do you make of it?
Every business plan I see, whether it's AI or not, of course, the thousands of plans all talk about AI. But I'll go back also to great leadership and vision. Michael Dell and Dell are absolutely going to be big winners in this next generation of AI. Mark Zuckerberg, who just turned 40, truly a genius. You look at what Steve Schwartzman and John Gray are doing at Blackstone, Henry Kravis and George Roberts at KKR. Leadership really matters, and yes, there is extraordinary hype, but I'm still spinning out small teams at very good valuations out of Stanford, MIT, Berkeley, Columbia, and a number of other top universities who really believe there's a next generation of AI opportunities that are all around very deep technology, these quantitative models, and small language models focused on very specific industries.
Jim, we'll leave it there. We've got to go. Jim Breyer, Breyer Capital, Jack Hidary of SandboxAQ, going to continue to watch your story. We'll be right back here on Money Movers.